for you when we come.
In fourth place after round seven. She's almost 5/10 of a point out of third. So that's a hard margin to make up.
She has the facial look of a young Julianne McNamara.
She has a very intense look, and I think this is why she's one of Bella's favorites. He really likes her work and her concentration. Beautiful position. Press to handstand, lowers to plunge. They have to show at least a 45-degree angle there to get credit. There's her gymnastics series requirement, two leaps in a row. She could have shown more split in the air. Two back handsprings, layout, step out. Nice and clean and a good landing.
Right now she is in fourth place. Looking up at Amanda Urick, but with a good opportunity to move ahead of her.
There's her gymnastics acrobatic series. You combine an acrobatic move with a dance element. It has to be directly connected. If that's missing, it's a 1/10 of a point deduction. That is a gorgeous move. Shushanova did that in the Olympic Games. It's a full twisting back handspring down, and she actually does it better than Elena did. It's a tough move. I can't tell you how difficult that move is. I wouldn't do it. Nice work here on the balance beam. She has an excellent look. Round off, double twist, and not very difficult dismount, but she is one of the most technically perfect gymnasts here.
She will need, if my numbers are right, she will need a 9.425 right. to move past Amanda Urick into third place.
Good job.
Here's another look.
This is a great move. It is so difficult. She does a full twist in the air. Finishes just in time to do a chest roll down onto the beam. I don't need to tell you what happens when you're a little bit off. That hurts.
Yes.
And the dismount, a round off double twist. Eventually she'd like to get a little more difficulty here on the dismount. And it's a great beam routine.
And she is obviously happy with it. She awaits her score now because she can move up a position here. Could move into the top three with a good score. My numbers tell me 9.425, and that is purely unofficial. Amy Scheer will be next on the beam, and she's coming off a very disappointing routine on bars a moment ago, so she's going to have to gather herself up.
Yes, she had two falls off the uneven bars.
Competition will come down to Shannon Miller and Kim Zemeskal. It is not out of the question for Shannon Miller yet, who will be in this final rotation in her best discipline, that being floor exercise. And Kim Zemeskal has to come off a tough bars routine onto the balance beam. Conference going on. And it's a conference that really has a profound effect on Erica Stokes.
It's boiled down to a really great competition between Shannon and Kim. Much closer than I even thought it would be beginning this competition today.
Yeah, you were saying that Kim Zemeskal really did basically have to fall, and she virtually did that.
But Shannon's done a terrific job. In fact, she started out today on her weakest event, scored a 9.475, which is great for her, and moved up.
Conference continues, and this one very important, of course, because we again talked about the significance of the junior national championships. Let's talk a little bit more about that. What does it really all mean in the great scheme of things?
Probably the most important thing here is the ranking. This will rank the gymnasts for a full year till the next championships and also help select them for international competition. So that's why we're seeing a lot of conferences. They're really making sure that they rank these gymnasts properly.
Well, in the men's competition last night, we told you that there are already three spots for the world championship team named, and there are still three to come, and so that was the motivation there, and there's even more motivation here, I think, because these are young gymnasts who are just now stepping into lineup. There is her score, 9.675. That is very good, and according to my unofficial calculations, that will move her ahead of Amanda Urick into third place. But it does mean that it comes down now to Kim Zemeskal and Shannon Miller. Erica Stokes, every reason to be proud. Right now, though, she and the crowd here at the Myriad Arena will focus their attention on the floor exercise routine of Shannon Miller. Now, this is probably her best event, the floor exercise. And as we mentioned, Kim Zemeskal is on what might be her most difficult. Last minute word from her coach, and Shannon Miller is set to go. As you see, she was first in the floor exercise at the American Classic earlier this year.
I think Shannon definitely had the luck of the draw here. She actually had the Olympic rotation. She started on vault, went to bars, beam, and now is ending on floor. And as you said, it's her best event, so she's got an opportunity for a real high score here. And of course, Kim, awaiting to do a balance good in competition. Very steady, very solid.
And she has the added pressure, remember, of being before the home folk.
A piked, full twisting double back. She's just really on today. Full twisting back handspring. She can relax a little bit here. She has nothing to lose. She's going to go all out, try and catch the leader. Two whip overs through to a double twist punch front. Good tumbling.
Listen to the crowd.
Back handspring to her hands, to pirouettes. Her gym acro series. She did a double turn right into a back handspring. Again, it has to be directly connected. She needs a little bit of work on her dance. She gets a little sloppy with her feet and her positions. But that can come in time and a lot of hard work.
Now, time is definitely the ally of just about everyone we've seen tonight. No exception here.
She was in trouble coming off on the takeoff. Very slow getting her arms up into that double back. Had trouble on the rotation. That's so unfortunate. She had a great routine up to that point.
Could very likely cost her the overall championship.
Take a look at her first pass. I was amazed on this pass. She actually tumbles very low to the ground, even considering her height. Heads very close to the floor there. This is a really pretty pass. She does two whip overs through to a double twist punch front. That was probably her best pass of the routine.
Now, how much will the bobble at the end cost her? Here it is.
That's a fall. 5/10 of a point deduction. Oh, just can't get it around. Ran out of gas. She covered well.
Yeah, very nice recovery.
That's definitely an improvisation.
But you saw her eyes go. Taking it for her, not only does she not catch Kim Zemeskal for first, Erica Stokes, again, as we mentioned, going away to Jim Kelly with her 9.675 on the balance beam. She now moves ahead of Shannon Miller. So Shannon Miller has actually dropped down into third place. Erica Stokes is second, and Kim Zemeskal, as she was at the beginning of tonight, the only constant, is in first place.
And she is on a pressure event right here. This is not the ideal situation to end on balance beam. Two layout step outs. But as I said earlier, she's tough in competition. I was very surprised she had that miss on uneven bars. So I know she's coming back with a vengeance here on beam.
Difficult task coming off and having to forget a misfortune not that long ago and coming up to what has to be considered your hardest event.
Two leaps in a row. That's her gymnastics series. She's moving quite well right now. She only needs an 8.885 to win on balance beam. But you never know what's going to happen on beam. And the dismount, round off, double back, just a one step on the ending. I know she's done it.
Well, that should be good enough.
All right, little piggy. No, that was nothing.
Well, that'll tell you that the winner of this competition is going to be Kim Zemeskal.
No, you're a competitor now.
She draws the plaudits of her coach, Bella Caroli. And Bella Caroli's troops, as we might have expected, have done a tremendous job today. So Zemeskal wins it, and Erica Stokes right now is second. Zemeskal, Jim, was... Kim Zemeskal wins it. Erica Stokes finishes second. Shannon Miller finishes third. Kathy, we talked to the...